Hey there, interwebs, and welcome back to How Fascinating. This episode was going to be part of March of the Megafauna, but it lost out to dinosaurs because, let's be honest, everything is going to lose to dinosaurs. Now, tell me, what do these three animals have in common? In case you're wondering, the one in the middle is a hyrax. The other two are an elephant and a sea cow, an African bush elephant and a West Indian manatee, to be specific. Give up? All three are panungulates, also known as subungulates, and, as a matter of fact, elephants, sea cows, and hyraxes are the only panungulates. That means these strange rodent-looking things' closest living relatives are elephants and sea cows. Before I go any further, I should warn you, this video is going to be a mantle of taxonomy wrapped around a fascinating kernel, and I made it because I'm a little too into taxonomy, so if the mere mention of the subject makes you break out in hives, stop watching now. As I was saying, the taxonomic clade Panungulata contains only three extant orders, elephants, sea cows, and hyraxes. Those first two are fairly closely related and belong to the clade Tethetheria. That means beasts of the Tethys Sea, which was named after the Greek Titan, who was the sister wife of Oceanus and the mother of the Oceanids and Potamoi, or river gods. This makes sea cows the elephant's closest living relatives, and knowing that, this comic from Man vs. Manatee makes a whole lot more sense. If you're the kind of person who reads webcomics but you don't read Man vs. Manatee, you really should, because the whole thing is so damn sweet it makes me want to vomit blood. Delving deeper, ocean pun absolutely intended, sea cows are more properly called Sirenia, and they can be broken down into dugongs and Old World and New World manatees. The Old World versus New World split among the manatees isn't an official distinction, but it's still helpful for understanding the three species. This portion of the fork can be further broken down like this, with Amazonian and West Indian manatees making up the New World species, and West African manatees being the sole Old World species. If you want to go further down the elephant rabbit hole, there are only three extant elephant species belonging to two genera. The genus Loxodonta contains the African bush elephant and the African forest elephant. This is also where the Loxodons from Unearthed Arcana get their name, and I'm still disappointed that the creators didn't instead name them Elephanthropes. Loxodon just sounds like they have bits of smoked salmon caught in their teeth. The genus Elephas contains only a single species, the Asian elephant. Basically, the point I'm getting at is elephants and sea cows are fairly closely related to one another, since they're the only two groups belonging to Tethetheria, which makes them kind of like siblings, and hyraxes are the weird cousins of this slightly strange family trait. Furthermore, just as hyraxes are the weird cousins to Tethetheria, so too are dugongs the weird cousins to manatees, and even Asian elephants are the weird cousins to African elephants or Loxodonta. If we look at our taxonomic fork for this episode, we've got siblings over here and weird cousins splitting off down here. Speaking of weird cousins, it's time to take a look at the hyrax, not to be confused with the haruspex. There are three living genera of hyrax: the rock hyrax, the yellow-spotted rock hyrax, also known as the bush hyrax, and the tree hyrax, and these are presumably strong against fire and water types, but weak against steel and poison, respectively. The rock hyrax and bush hyrax genera only contain one species each, but the tree hyrax or dendrohyrax genus contains three species: the southern tree hyrax, the eastern tree hyrax, and the western tree hyrax. When it comes to hyraxes, there's actually some debate in the scientific community as to what's a species and what's just a subspecies, but isn't there always? In conclusion, you've got panungulates made up of Tethetheria and hyraxes. Tethetheria is elephants and sea cows. Elephants are made up of Loxodonta, the African bush elephant and the African forest elephant, and the Asian elephant. Sea cows are manatees and dugongs, and manatees are the Old World West African manatees and the New World West Indian and Amazonian manatees. Hyraxes are comprised of the rock hyrax and the bush hyrax, as well as the southern, eastern, and western tree hyraxes. I was prepared to make a joke about this being my March Madness bracket, but this episode got cut from March of the Megafauna. And then COVID-19 hit and March Madness got cut from reality, so there goes that joke. Anyway, thanks for watching, and have a fascinating day.